Before I get going, I want to just state this. This is totally educational. This is not advice. This is how I'm looking at things. You should seek outside help, like a financial advisor, if you are looking for advice on some of these tactics or these companies. The other night I was on TikTok. I don't know if you've ever checked this out, but you should. And all of a sudden what was coming up in my feed was these stock recommendations. And they were coming from, well, not your traditional stockbroker or day trader kind of person. No longer was it guys my age in their 50s, but more like teenagers who are pumping stocks, like small cap stocks, micro cap stocks, that they were like, check these out over the weekend because these are the stocks that are going to break out for the coming week. With Metcalfe's law applied to this, this has become not about the company per se, but about the network behind the company, the network of people touting the stock and pushing the stocks higher. I believe this has all come about because of COVID. A year ago, people started to be, well, being quarantined and told to stay home. And then they lost their jobs. And then they started getting $600 checks. And for a lot of those people in the service industry, those $600 checks were bigger than the checks they were bringing home during the time they were working. Well, I got to thinking about, what if I was working a service job and I started getting $600 a month. I was stuck at home and I found Robinhood, the trading platform. And my cost of living was pretty low. So that $600 a week actually had a lot extra. And I got on TikTok because I didn't have any place to go. I was quarantined. I couldn't go out because my state basically closed down. Well, I'm sitting here watching people talk about companies and buying these companies and becoming rich. So let's say you took $200 of your $600 weekly paycheck. You bought 200 shares of one of these $1 stocks that you saw on TikTok. And that stock all of a sudden grew 100% in that week. Well, number one, you'd be out of your mind excited. Like, you've just made more money than you did in a whole week working a job 9 to 5. And what if you did that every week for 12 weeks straight? 100% increases on that initial $100, and you reinvested the gains. Over 12 weeks, do you know how much you would have? $819,200. Holy cow. And what's happening is some people are actually achieving this. 100% returns on these $1, you know, penny stocks, because they're all being affected by Metcalfe's law. Penny stocks are affordable to the masses. These are companies that in the past typically won't be bought by people who use a financial advisor. And the reason for that is because those stocks are off limits because they're below $5. It's the same with institutions like pension funds or mutual funds. Typically, you will not see these companies being bought by big asset management firms because they are penny stocks. But one thing that I believe is happening is that the masses have found a way to get into this market at a low cost. They're focusing on companies that they think should go higher. And I think some of them are just really pump and dump type situations. And you see that with GameStop, you've seen that with AMC Theaters here recently. But what's more important, I believe, is that network effect, that effect of groups of people who have been really left out of the gains of the stock market over the last 10 years. And now they're being able to get in the market. They're able to, in some cases, take the big asset managers down to their knees in some cases, as we saw with Melvin Capital and GameStop. But now they have a way to invest, and all of a sudden these penny stocks, they're blowing up. I mean, every week I hear about some company that was 85 cents a share, all of a sudden is $4, $5, $10 a share. And people are making 100, 200, 300, up to 1,000 times on their money in a matter of a week, 2 weeks or so. Now, the big platforms that are pushing this are on Reddit, the group Wall Street Bets. They are the ones being credited for the AMC Theaters, along with GameStop's upward movement over the last 6 months or so. This is a group that I believe at one time in July was maybe 400,000 people in it. And today, from what I understand, it's close to 9 million people who are a part of this group. And it's a basically a chat room type situation like we saw back in the late 90s in Yahoo chats. And they're talking about stocks they like. And some of them are really legitimate analysis about these companies and what they could be doing. And so I believe what is happening is this Metcalfe law, the effect of the network is becoming a way to find companies that, good or bad, are easy to put money to, doesn't take a lot of capital, but in the end are going to go skyrocketing higher. The other platform that you can find this on is Twitter. You can find different groups like some of the Wall Street Bets is on there along with some other groups, and they post ideas every day throughout the day with stocks to buy, stocks to short, using some derivative products and so on. This past Friday, I actually went ahead and bought one of these stocks through a more of a derivatives play. And I sat there all day watching this thing. And it was really interesting, the amount of volume in comparison to the previous day's open interest was gigantic. And it showed up on my Twitter feed by one of these companies or one of these groups. And basically they just gave the stats on this thing. And I thought, wow, that's interesting. So I dabbled into it. Well, looked at my account balance today on that position. Holy cow. The whole Metcalfe law scenario really is kicking in. And I'm really interested to see what happens on Tuesday when the market opens up again with this position. So you say to me, Trent, I have another job. How do I go through all these different sites like Twitter and Reddit? And how do I identify what companies that these guys are really looking at? Well, here's how I'm looking at it. Number one, I go on TikTok, 15, 20 minutes, if I can limit it to that. And I look for companies that these people are talking about. And I just take an inventory list. And what I do when I go through TikTok in particular is I identify the companies that are repeated over and over and over again. And those are become my higher up picks. I then go to Reddit and Wall Street Bets and I check out what they're talking about. And in most cases, they're still talking about GameStop and AMC Theaters, but they also are talking about some of the stuff they're talking about on TikTok. And I go through there and I add this stuff up. And then over this weekend, I found this trending website, WSBtrending.com. And what this is some guy basically wrote a program to go and scan through Wall Street Bets feeds and identify the stocks they're talking about. And then once he's identified the stocks they're talking about, he identifies the number of times they are mentioned throughout the feed in a 24-hour period. And what it gives you is this ranking of roughly 100 positions or so from the top talked about all the way down to the least talked about. And what I'm finding after watching this is the rate of change on some of these positions. So that position I bought on Friday, it has been moving up and down the feed overall throughout the last 24 hours. Between the time I discovered this site and the time that I shot this video. And what I'm finding is, as they move up in the feed, the popularity of that position in the market is actually growing. Once I have identified 10 or so positions, I'm then going to the charts and I'm looking at them going, okay, have they broken out? Are they overdone? Have they overextended their stay at this point? Or are they more in that development stage before a breakout to the higher side of things? And so I'm looking for those positions that are more in favor of building a base and starting to look like they're going to break out. Of course, I go to the fundamentals. I want to know what these companies do. I want to understand why they're being talked so much about. A lot of them, they're more of alternative energy companies, little electric vehicle type companies, electric vehicle battery type companies. But some of them are just, you know, retailers who basically taken it on the chin in the last year. And we're seeing, and their prices have been so depressed that they're now becoming really good opportunities for a short-term trade. Now, what I'm telling you and how I'm going about this is, this is a short-term trade. I'm not looking at this as something that is a long-term investment. I'm going to be in this for, you know, 3 months or more. This is, I may be in it for 3 hours. I'm looking for a quick pop that I can allocate at the most 6% of my capital to this, buy it in on the low side, get a pop out of it, hit my target return that I'm looking for in my position, and then just exiting. I don't care if it keeps going higher. I just don't want it to go lower, and I don't want it to blow me up. So sizing of my investment is really, really key, along with having a target return that I'm trying to get out of this position. See, I believe that if you have a idea of what you want to get out of it, if it's a 10, 20, 30% return or a dollar amount, I want to make, you know, a buck a share or 50 cents a share on this position, well, I believe that's the safer way of going through this process. The other thing is cutting my losses. And this is where charting and technical analysis really comes into play. So I'm charting my position. I'm looking at what their drawdown has been over the last, say, 15 to 30 days. And I put that as more of my stop position. And then from there, when I get into the position, I slowly size up until it breaks out, until I believe I've made the most out of it or I've hit my target return, and then I get out. Like everything, I believe this will come to an end at some point. But what I do believe is here to stay is Metcalfe's law, and that is the power of networks and the value of networks. And as these networks grow and people discover the ability to invest money into the market in these low-cost positions, not these high-cost positions like Amazon or Berkshire Hathaway or something like that, but companies that the average person can buy 100, 200, 300 shares of and allocate, you know, $100 to $300 to $1,000 to and grow that capital into something sizable, I believe this is going to continue in that form. Now, will there be a meltdown of some sort? History says yes. At some point, this will retrace, this will all subside to up for a period of time. But I do believe this network effect is here to stay. And as long as you can trade for zero commissions and you can allocate small amounts of capital and risk manage around this, I think is going to be, well, the future of investing.